The bride and her relatives serve as communal gatherings where tradition is not merely observed but actively lived, fostering a sense of collective identity that reverberates through generations. Literary heritage and oral narratives. As Swatini's literary heritage weaves a tapestry of oral narratives and written expressions, from ancient tales passed down through generations to contemporary literary works, the written and spoken word become vessels of cultural trotrae. By the ceremony, nearby river, eat goat or cow meat offered by groom's family. In the afternoon, they dance in the groom's homestead. On Sunday morning, the bride with her female relatives stabs ground with a spear in man's cattle kraal. Later she is smeared with red ochre. The smearing is the high point of marriage. No woman can be smeared twice. Bride presents gifts to husband and his relatives. Umlanga is one of the well-known cultural events in Eswatini held in August in Elavokati, depending on the phases of the moon. This ceremony, also known as the First Fruits ceremony, marks the king's tasting of the new harvest. The Swazi nation, as we know it today, originally came from Mozambique. Their Nguni ancestors probably moved there before the 16th century as part of the Bantu migration. Archaeologists have found human remains in eastern Swaziland, then dated to be year Swazi fled from there originally in Haital and Mnaltalpire. The Swazi, ruled by Sapusa, Eye of the Dlamini, to transfer to the Isilwini Valley in the area we know as Swaziland today. Sapusa was the son of Nguni, who the Swazi recognize as their first king. The Swazi people drove away most of the Sotho groups in the area, and Sapusa became the most powerful ruler in the region. He also managed to avoid the worst of the Mthwai. The next Swazi king to take the throne was Mthwai. Then he exsegrated. When his term ended in, the Swazi nation was secure. During the as European settlers, traders, missionaries and hunters moved into the area with the intention of making it their home. Though the Swaziland Convention of ensured the area's independence, it made the kingdom a great deal smaller. This independence was largely on paper and in. This arrangement continued until when the kingdom became a high commission territory under the rulership of a British commissioner. For the next years, Swaziland remained under British control. Many Swazi men left their homes to raise money as mine workers to buy parts of their land back. British rule in the kingdom was peaceful and by limited self-government was allowed. On September, Swaziland was granted complete independence. It was still a member of the Commonwealth of Nations and the king, Sapusa I, cabinet and parliament. The Swaziland constitution was a product of its previous British rulers and in King Sapusa I suspended it. He felt that it did not reflect the culture of the Swazi people. A new constitution was drawn up and presented in. This new constitution made the king the absolute ruler of the kingdom. Sapusa stayed in power until, when Prince Mako stood as his successor, he was crowned as the ministers in South Eden, agreement regarding each other's security interests. Swaziland would deport all African National Congress ANC members to South Africa. This did not prevent raids by the South African police in search of ANC operatives. Cultural mosaic and artistic expressions within the kaleidoscope of Eswatini's cultural mosaic, artistic expressions of Varisevi. The artistic landscape encapsulates the diversity canvas, woven with threads of tradition and innovation, echoes the dynamic interplay between heritage and the evolving currents of artistic exploration. Diversification of economic strategies. Amidst the economic tapestry, Eswatini explores avenues for diversification, acknowledging the imperative of resilience in the face of global economic shift, the nation's economic pyramid, the narrative of adaptability, navigating the complexities of a globalized economic landscape, evolving social dynamics, the societal fabric of Eswatini undergoes a continuous evolution, mirroring global trends while retaining its unique cultural nuances. The intersection of tradition and modernity shapes social dynamics, with shifts in gender roles, educational aspirations, and community structure. Sustainable conservation of woods of change. Sustainable conservation practices positioned at the forefront. The commitment to preserving biodiversity extends beyond borders, finding expression in national parks and reserves. Eswatini's dedication to environmental sustainability becomes a testament to the recognition that the well-being of its natural landscapes in Eswatini is marked by initiatives that extend beyond borders, reflecting a commitment to global collaboration. Nation's response to health crisis emphasizes the interconnectedness of global well-being, with initiatives ranging from have educational empowerment and knowledge transmission. Educational empowerment and knowledge transmission. Educational institutions emerge as crucibles of empowerment, fostering a culture of knowledge transmission that spans generations. From the Swazi National School to institutions, the transmission of wisdom align with the vision of an empowered citizenry, contributing to the nation's developmental tapestry. Eswatini's diplomatic engagements unfold against the backdrop of regional relations, with a recognition of the interconnectedness that defines the Southern African landscape. Bilateral and multilateral collaborations become instrumental of navigating geopolitics that shape the Southern African region. Traditions and gastronomic delights. The culinary tapestry of Eswatini is woven with a rich array of traditional flavors and gastronomic delights. from the savoring of staple foods like maize to the communal aspects of preparing and sharing meals. Culinary traditions become a mirror reflecting the communal spirit and cultural pleasures of communal dining. Cultural diplomacy and global representation, and the sensory pleasures of communal dining, showcasing its heritage on international platforms. Cultural exchanges become a means of fostering global understanding and appreciation for the nations of fostering global understanding and appreciation for the nation's heritage and traditions. Me.